Facility now secure.
Finally, you are most welcome.
You said it's an emergency.
Our work sphere has just been confirmed. Empty Hemp Pulse is back.
Did you know yet?
Unfortunately, that is precisely the case. In fact, they have already started to showcase themselves to the fullest maximum. Now, we try so much to keep them in shape, but then they are always one step in our future. Now, it didn't matter whether they are cool or they are not cool. What really matters is that they are having a network that permits them to showcase the character that they truly have. I'm so sorry, but this you cannot purchase in the market.
We must stop them.
I'm afraid to be the carrier of a bad news, but it's already late.
Facility security breach.
I think we've lost the war.
CSO, what are you doing?
You mean myself? I'm moving to Empty Hemp Pulse with immediate effect.
How? Oh.
Good evening and welcome to the entertainment segment of PTV News. I am Ina Peters. Wizkid has never been one to shy away from expressing love and gratitude for his parents. The singer dropped sweet birthday messages for his mother, Jane Dolapo Balungu. He wrote, "Happy birthday to the love of my life, my backbone, my everything. I do this for you. More life." Also, 2 years ago, Wizkid expressed his love and gratitude for his parents, saying he owes everything he has to them. In his own words, "They gave me everything they had, even when they had nothing. I can't put words together to express how much I love you, Mom and Dad. I'll always make you proud." Meanwhile, Wizkid was nominated in the BET's in the Best International Act African category. The award was, however, given to South Africa's Black Coffee.
My girl, they make me lose my mind. I give her what she needs. My girl, they make me lose my mind. Another girl, another scene.
The entertainment scene was taken aback with news of the band's secret wedding, said to have gone down on Saturday, July 2nd, 2016. One question you might ask, though, is why we should be surprised when Dibanj had told us that he was married as long as 7 months ago. A video of the singer made 7 months ago has surfaced where he said he was married. In the video, he said he did not want his marriage to be a public affair, and so he went on the cover cop, according to him.
Yes, because what happened is that I thought to myself that am I going to do a public marriage because everybody's going to see me married. When everybody see me married, then they're going to say, Bangali has married. So I did not want to do that because I don't want them to come and be seeing me like that. So I did undercover cop. So what I've done now is that as you are seeing me now, I'm now Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Because I'm now already married, but I don't want you to know I'm already married. And I'm going to wait like that, like R. Kelly wait 15 years. R. Kelly wait 15 years before he knows he don't marry. KC!
Respect your fear. Bye-bye.
And my role model is KC. My role model is KC when it comes to that thing. Why can't you ask KC when he's going to get married?
Of course, at that time, it all seemed the Coco Master was making a good joke, but just maybe he wasn't. Meanwhile, he might have just dropped a new hint to confirm his marriage in a new video that's gone viral online. In the video, Dibanj sends a special birthday shout out to his stylist Swanky Jerry, and at the end of the video says, "Swanky, when you are done celebrating, call me up for some wedding things." Now, while some sources are certain of the Dibanj new status as a married man, others are skeptical, especially as there are no traces of the artist's mystery wife on any social media platform. The mystery woman Didi Kilgrove is said to be part Nigerian and part South African. She is believed to have grown up in Jos and is the half sister of MTV VJ Samantha Walsh. And on a sad note, a candlelight procession has been held for the late music producer OJB Jizrael on July 4th, the day he would have celebrated his 50th birthday. His friend and colleague Rugged Man, who was present at the candlelight procession, penned a touching tribute in honor of OJB. Initially confused about what to say, he stated that July 4th was a day he would have loved to wish OJB a happy birthday, but instead he was planning his funeral. Saying he was honored to have met him, Rugged Man said about Jizrael, "You blessed me with your friendship and production skills that added great value to my life and career. You gave the Nigerian music industry countless and unforgettable hits." The candlelight procession kicked off at his residence in Surulere, Lagos, and moved through Bode Thomas Street, the stadium area of Surulere, and ended with prayers back at his home. Some other celebrities present were DJ Jimmy Jatt, Wizkid's manager Sunday Are, Noah Loss's manager Joyce Izzy Iyamu, and Wale Oluwalemu. OJB died on Tuesday, June 14, 2016, after complications arose from his kidney ailment. His wakekeep and service of song is to be held on Thursday, July 7, 2016, at the National Stadium, Surulere, while the funeral will be held the following day on Friday, July 8, 2016, at his residence, also in Surulere. While it might not be a big deal to get a driving license in this part of the world, Lady Gaga seems pretty excited about finally getting her driving license at age 30. The American singer got her license after years of driving with a learner's permit and an adult present. She was given a license after she passed her road test in California. She took to Instagram to share a picture of the driver's license school and another one of her driving. Meanwhile, Lady Gaga has taken a break from music to pursue her acting career. Last year, she played the role of the vampire queen in the fifth season of TV series American Horror Story. Apparently, she was so good at it that she won a Golden Globe for her role. This entertainment news is brought to you by MTN. And that's all on entertainment news for tonight. My name is Ina Peters.